Hi.
Hello.
Nice to see you here. Nice to see you in Kyiv. How you describe what you see here?
I think that this is most likely the most active defense tech startup events now in the world. Because I'm just surprised how many products are here. And most importantly, how many of those products is combat used? How many of those products is basically already working and making impact? I'm super impressed.
What do you think about Ukrainian and West market like about market? Where some money, some ideas, how all of this work and how it's look like in other countries, this defense innovation environment?
I believe that Ukraine is today the most active defense tech ecosystem. There is no any other country which has so many startups, 2,000, and so many products which built the highest speed, tested, new version. And also there is one very unique thing about Ukraine, which maybe you don't understand, that startups who has product can very fast sell this, can very fast actually make a revenue. This is a very unique thing in the world because in every other country still, most of them, all NATO and allies, the sale process is very slow. It takes 3-4 years. But here, if you build a product, you find way how to make revenue and sell that. And that's super unique because it helps to speed up development and basically development of the company and the product.
How do you think our projects, it's more markets of ideas or it's market of companies?
I think that this is more market of products. Like really, because many of those teams don't have a company yet. Many of those teams using NGO, foundation and other things. You know, I have been in Ukraine from 2011. And what I always loved and why I come back is the highest quality of engineering. Ukraine has always, you know, been in space, in aviation and so on. And now in defense, because of this horrible war, this talent is really focused. Like almost every founder I know is doing defense now. They did something else before, but now they are doing defense. And the best people are now really globally are doing this here.
You know, there are some stories about other investors. They say, oh, it's kill people. We don't want to invest in such products. Are you an offensive investor?
I think that if you want to win the war, you have to liquidate your enemy, black and white. You cannot win the war if you don't liquidate the enemy. Yes, we will invest to the lethal solutions. I don't think that defense tech investor can be only who doing dual use. That's a joke, sorry. Defense tech investor is someone who is ready to invest defense tech things, which some of them are lethal.
How you make decisions where to invest? Which company need investment? What is the basic list of capabilities of the company?
I think that I am entrepreneur and all of our teams, all of the people in Darkstar entrepreneurs. So first thing for us is the people, the team, who they are, what drives them, what motivates them. And the next thing is indeed the product. And what we are looking is what is the highest impact on the front line today, but what product can help NATO to rebuild global security. And indeed, the number three thing which we look, which companies we can personally help, because we are looking if we invest that we are team members, how much I and so many other people which behind the Darkstar can sit down with founder and help them. So these are three most important criteria for us.
But you need some expertise from NATO armies that they really need some solutions. How organize this process, this NATO expertise about Ukrainian products?
We have in the team people who has been in defense tech like 5 years. We have people who has been all life in defense. So we have actual, you know, colonels and so on. So we are really exactly, and we are asking feedback. Like I have organized Ukraine startups meeting in Estonia with Estonian army, with defense ministry. I have people in Czech Republic who are waiting, hey, please bring here. So Darkstar is really working in, our members are in many countries in the world, mainly in Europe, France, Germany, Czech Republic. And many of those people have been in defense a long time. And they are exactly giving us advice and giving this seems relevant. We are focusing more electronic warfare, everything about the drones. We are not like looking something which is very high price and you build next tank. What we are focusing is highly scalable, and the price of the unit should be less than 20,000. Because if it's too expensive, it's a little bit different market and our know-how is not good, sir. What we are looking is companies, a product which can be scaled into tens of thousands.
And how Ukrainian startups can work at the European NATO market of innovations?
So the one thing that we help, basically Ukrainian companies, is help them immediately make company in Estonia and also open bank account, because that's a real problem. It could take you 2-3 months. Because if you want to be to a NATO country, you need to have presence in Europe. And that's the first step that we always push them. Hey, you have to open company. We are running meetups in Tallinn. We had the Czech Republic and so on. So we are exactly thinking that if you want to be in the NATO radar, you have to be present. You have to visit. You have to meet and so on. That's the, one of the things. And we help not only companies, but we invest, but we build an ecosystem. We help other companies who we see is a great companies. Because we are looking beyond our investment. We are looking how connect this unique connection that we have between Ukraine and Estonia. Estonia has e-government, e-residence, and so on. How to build basically this unique gateway that Ukrainian promising companies can enter Estonia and from that to other NATO countries.
For us, it's a little bit of conflict because we want our company to stay in Ukraine, but for them, it's important to have some companies in Estonia, in Czech Republic, or in Poland, so on. But how do you think? It's normal process, or it's some problems for future, for Ukrainian economy, Ukrainian industries?
It's not. It's a very common thing. So I am co-founder of Pipedrive. Our HQ was in US. We always talked Pipedrive is an Estonian company. The fact is, if Ukrainian company want to receive serious investment, two things. It have to have company in EU or even US. And second, it have to have clear way how to make revenue outside of Ukraine. That's the investors type what I know. There are different type of investors, but startup people looking how this can grow. And I don't think it's a conflict. We are not taking away. You have production here. You keep helping. The key question is, from these 2,000 companies and teams in Ukraine, how to help bigger numbers survive? Because so many of them don't have investment. So many of them are running out of capital. So many of them will just one moment, you know, close down the doors. Our focus is that from this, the best companies have opportunity to build global national security. Because one thing which is maybe unique here is that if we look this, what has happened in the last 2.5 years in Ukraine, in the defense tech and army, then if this trend goes, then Ukraine army will be second most developed army in the world after Israel in the next 1-2 years. Because no any other army besides Israel is developing so fast. Unmanned things, all electronic warfare, which means it's not only products. Ukraine soldiers, when the war starts, will help to rebuild all armies in the world, because they are the real warriors, they are the real soldiers, they know what means being in the war.
The main focus for our soldiers, it's true. So what is the main risk for investors to invest in Ukraine?
Legal system, like if you invest legal system, and also at this moment, Ukraine has still export restrictions. There is problem with Ukraine founders' permissions to leave country. There is still some problems is that the team members could work and not be mobilized. There are many, but biggest risk is even outside of Ukraine, the biggest risk is how much NATO is changing procurement. Because here it's fast, the fastest thing in the world, but rest of the world living in the peacetime rules. So that's a risk that if you build here, it might still take you 3 years before NATO buys, or even 5 years. Because most of the procurement outside of Ukraine is built for the huge enterprises like Rheinmetall, like Helsing, like Anduril and Palantir. So that's a risk that many of companies, even though they have a good product, they would not, governments would not accept them as our partners.
Maybe some advice for investors who don't have a decision invest to Ukraine or not?
I think that first of all, the question is, are you a defensive investor? Are you looking at the best teams? The best teams are here. That's the way it is.
Only in Ukraine.
Like there are indeed also Israel, let me be frank. But the fastest developing are now in Ukraine and Israel. This is the fastest because there is no so fast environment like in these two countries.
What about advice for companies? How to find your investor?
I think that it's very difficult. Let me be frank. Many people who is now building defense tech, they have other backgrounds. They are startup, they are software, hardware, everything. It's so much more different. You have less investors, and founders should share each other contact. They should actively go out, should visit other events in other countries and approach. One more thing. There is a new wave of investors now. Basically, almost 80% of members of a coalition have never, ever invested defense before. But the world has changed. So I would say that founders should really go and look entrepreneurs who can be their angel investors and who can be the fastest. Because funds, I think that there are in Europe 5 to 7 funds which can invest a little, not more. That's it. In all Europe. Why? Because of European Investment Bank and many pension funds and so on doesn't allow that. And all funds said, no, we can only do dual use.
So now is the best time to invest to Ukrainian startups?
I think that it is best because this team has been already around 1 year, 2 years. They have a product. And this is very unique that you can invest to a company which has a working product.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.